Can I do it? He made me laugh. That's why. He's like, I said it, and he was like, I didn't know he was gonna hold it. So he held it, and he was like, that's why I started laughing. That's why.
Good morning, church. Come on in, have a seat. Good morning. Come on in, everybody. Come on in, have a sit down. Let me officially welcome you. I welcome you in the name of our Lord and our Savior, Jesus the Christ. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Just a quick announcement, then we're going to turn it over to our worship team. I just want to make a mention real quick for the church bulletin. Some folks are asking when things are happening, and they want to know when and so forth and details. If you could sign up, there's a list or a sign-up sheet on the back table there underneath the monitor. Just sign up to receive the bulletin electronically. You can get a bulletin that has all the details, everything that's going on, that you can see what's happening here at the church, so you can get involved, or just so you'll know. Sign up on the back table there. Get your name on the distribution list so that you can get the bulletin electronically. Amen? Amen. Okay. I'm going to turn it over to the worship team.
Won't you stand?
You live, you die, you said in 3 days you would rise, you did, you're alive. You rule, you reign, you said you're coming back again, I know you will. You take our sins away, oh God. You give your life away for us. You came down, you saved us through the wrong. Our hearts are changed because of your great love. You live, you die, you said it. Back again, I know.
The victory is ours.
Make it glorious. Make it wonderful. Make it excellent, the praises of our King. Make it glorious. Make it wonderful. Make it excellent, the praises of our King. Make it glorious. Make it wonderful. Make it excellent, the praises of our King. Make it glorious. Make it wonderful. The praises of our King. Make it passionate, given from our heart. Sing praises to our King. Make it passionate, make it beautiful. The praises of our King. Is worthy of praise.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, I worship your holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul, I worship your holy name. The sun comes up, it's a new day dawning, it's time to sing your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes. Sing out to him, let's go. Bless the Lord.
Oh, my soul.
Worship.
always unending. 10,000 years and then forever.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, I worship His holy name, sing like never before, oh my soul, worship Your holy name, bless the
sing like never before, oh my soul, I worship Your holy name. Yes, I will worship Your holy name. Lord, I worship Your holy name.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me, bless His holy name. All that is within me, bless His holy name. All that is within me, bless His holy name. I bless You with my mind, and with my emotions, with my will. Lord, I bless Your holy name. Bless Your holy name. You are worthy of praise. It says, if we won't praise Your name, then the rocks and stones will cry out. It says, all the earth rejoices. All the earth spins on its axis of who You are.
Never will come between the love we share. We set our eyes upon the beauty of Your face, oh Lord. Father, Your glorious, Your name is wonderful.
Nothing can or ever will come between the love we share. We set our eyes upon the beauty of Your face, oh Lord. Father, Your glory, Your name is one. Stand in awe of You.
forever.
Forever.
Forever, you are faithful. Forever, you are true. Forever, you are mighty. Forever, it is you. Forever, you are faithful. Forever, you are true. Forever, you are mighty. Forever, it is you.
God, mighty King, we make our lives an offering, and on this day we make a pact to live for you and not turn back. We set our eyes upon the beauty of your face, O Lord. Father, your glory. Thank you. forever and ever. I was standing on you. 10,000 years from now, standing on of you. 10,000 years from now, I'll stand in awe of you. Forever, 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 worship you, for you are worthy of praise. Forever and ever and ever, you are faithful, O God. That we can give an answer to that question, where we'll be 1,000 years from now, where we'll be 10,000 years from now. Lord, we'll be standing in your presence, Lord God. Lord, we'll be surrounded by your glory. We thank you, Father God. Thank you for the blood of Jesus. Thank you for Calvary. Thank you for your grace. Thank you for your mercy. Your loving kindness endures forever, forever, and forever. Thank you, Lord God. We give you all the praise, all the glory, for you are worthy. In Jesus' name, amen, amen, amen. Why don't you be seated?
Well, praise the Lord. Just a couple of quick announcements, and we got a full schedule today. Just want to make another mention about the bulletin, the church bulletin, so that you can get an electronic copy of everything that's going on in church so you can be aware of what's happening and when it's happening. And secondly, I want to mention about baptism. We have a special baptism that we're going to be doing next week, a special time next week. If you want to get baptized or you're feeling led to do that or with your children or someone close to you, please sign up on the back table. There's going to be a list there for you to sign up on. We need to get your name on the list so we'll know exactly who's coming and how many people we need to prepare for. Amen? Amen. Amen. Now, visitors, if you're visiting with us for the very first or second time, I need you to just stand up for a quick second. If you're visiting with us for the first or the second time, I need you to please remain standing. Please remain standing. Don't sit down yet. Thank you. Thank you so very much for worshiping with us. Listen, we want to bless you. Our ushers are going to rush over. We got a nice packet for you. Inside that packet, some general information about the church. We ask that you take just a few moments today or tomorrow, whenever, and read through the information. If you got questions, call us here at the main office. We'll be more than happy to answer those questions for you. There are two cards in there. One, we need you to complete for your first-time visitors. It's a card so that we can recognize and record your visit. What we want you to do with that card is go to that back table there underneath the big monitor, turn that card in, a completed card, and you're going to get a gift card to Chick-fil-A so you can go out and have a bite on us. Second card is, and it applies to everyone, is a prayer request card. And this is what we do as a staff. We pray over each and every prayer request as it comes in. So we ask that you complete a prayer request card. If you're believing and trusting God for something, drop it in the offering tray and just believe and know that we'll be standing with you and believing with you with what you're believing God for. Amen?
Amen.
All right. And one more quick thing, girls' night out on the 25th of August. Didn't forget it. Amen. If you got questions, you can call Miss Linda Hoppe at the main office. Amen.
Amen. All right. We got a, I did great. Yeah, I think they're getting Terry. We got a lot of things to work in this morning, plus a movie. No popcorn, though. Sorry about that. But we do have coffee and things like that over there. So we do have a little different look this morning as you came in. We have a stage that's extended. Right now, we have about four different colors of carpet up there, but that's all right. We'll change that at some point. You know, next, we got to build some stairs, steps that are going to come off about here and curve into there. But we figured we'd just start with extending it. We got that done in a couple of days, so we'll add the second parts. And as you see, the set is gone. We moved that out. Somebody took a breath like you didn't even notice that. And what we're going to be having is some HD projectors that we're putting up here. So we'll be using lights and actual images and things and keeping it very simple. Maybe some of those, I don't know what you call them, kind of shears things that we had hanging in between the columns that we'll use just to, you know, use lights to give some different looks. But main thing is create space, and we're moving the band to the center because if you know anything about acoustic, it's an acoustical nightmare to have your band in the corner of the room. You guys over here that don't like loud music are sitting over here all the time to get away from the band, but we're going to move it a little closer to you so we get a balanced sound throughout the house is what we're after. So just some good things coming. The letters aren't here yet. Actually, they sent me the quote, and I said, let's do it. And then the guy replied back, said, Pastor, let's wait for the samples and see it because once you order it, there's no return. So I said, okay. But I was ready to move on it, but it should be this week that we actually get to look at the samples of the lettering that's going on the wall. It's going to say, loving God, loving others, and living intentionally with a red at the Freedom Center Church. And then over here, we're putting the Lord's Prayer back with just a different, more modern font. You'll see the Lord's Prayer there. Then under that will be salvation, deliverance, and healing under that of the Lord's Prayer. So that'll be over on that wall instead of over on that wall. Anyhow, so it's coming. Amen. Slowly but surely. If you'd like to give the Nehemiah Project, you can still do that. Believe me, we can find places to use that money. We built this ourselves so that we could save money for other things. Hallelujah. Didn't know what I was doing, but we got it done. And believe me, there's plenty of lumber over there underneath there. It is not coming down. They said, I think that'll hold. That's enough. I said, no, I'm using every bit of wood that's sitting over there is going in there. So we did. Amen. I want to show you a quick video of this. We're going to be doing each week a little video promoting some things that are coming up in the fall. And one of them and some things that will be kind of resetting for the fall. We have Bible Connections currently going on, but some of those classes will be kind of resetting with marriage. I think enrichment is one of those classes, different things that are going on there. But I just encourage you. It is important. We have resources. The Lord has resources with wonderful, gifted people and teachers. And so we have that going on Bible Connection classes over there that's in between the two services. It starts at 9:15, concludes at 10:15. And it's just a wonderful time. A lot of options there. I mean, there's things about giftings with a prophecy class. There's something there for the young people. There's something there for the college. There's marriage enrichment. There's a wisdom class. Some of those are Bible kind of more expository type classes, like Dr. Dave's class, wonderful class, Clarence's class. It's just good resources there for you. And so, Tom, roll the clip on that.
Hi, my name is Carlos, and what Bible Connect class means to me is a way to fellowship with my fellow brothers in church, and it has taught me, it has opened me up spiritually, it has taught me how to be more open to the Word of God.
Hi, Bruce and Ruby, and we attend a Bible study and a home group, and we love it because we can connect with people, and of course God's Word's important, and we love it for that we have the opportunity to learn God's Word and what it means for us.
So Bible Connections is a place where we as individuals who come from many different backgrounds and many different experiences come together to try and help one another and build each other with the experiences and the things that we have learned so that we come together as a unified body of Christ.
Amen. Amen. Give Tom just a moment to reset the video. Nothing else. Come here, Kara. Down where she's. I have. Parent, probably the most tense over the Atlantic Ocean to there and coming back. And boy, thank you for your prayers for her. I just say that as a parent. This was a big deal for me to let go, you know, and allow her to do that. But it was something just so much in her heart to do that I knew sooner or later she's going to do it one way or the other. So I better accommodate that process. And the Lord just worked it out beautifully. And so I wanted her to share her heart with you for a moment. And she's got a little video to share with you as well.
Good morning. Actually, it was really funny. Whenever I had gotten over there and got settled down, I called my dad. And I was like, because I wasn't sure, like, what type of facility I was going to be staying at. I was like, I'm staying at a retirement community. And he's like, oh, I already know where you are. There's a golf course close by. I've seen it all. So, but I appreciate all of your prayers. Thank you so much and for just helping me out because it was blessed, and that was because of y'all. So, Tom, if we could play the video real quick.
Faces and frames, the love and the pain.
I'll say I've never seen in my whole life the joy that those kids had. A lot of them have been to the camp before, and they look forward to it all year long. We make memory books during the week, and we give them pictures that they can keep in, and we write down our name and contact information, even though they probably won't get to use it until they get out of the orphanage. But they will bring them back in their backpacks and flip through the pictures. And I can't talk with them, but they'll point to the pictures and just show me. And although there was a language barrier, and I would try and talk about God, but they felt it, and they would, that joy that they had, it was because of Jesus, and they were experiencing the joy of God whenever they were there. And I have three things now that I'm back that I have to do, and I need y'all's help. But before I tell you about those three things, I want you to just get a little idea about the culture. And this is just what I experienced. I love China so much, but their culture is different than ours. And I was talking to a girl who's my translator. She was my age, and she said, honestly, before coming to this camp, I had no idea that there were special needs children. At my schools, I never saw them, not one, because in their family, it's looked upon as a curse, and it's bad for their image, and so they'll give them to an orphanage or send them away, or, you know. And I'm not saying everyone is like that, but that is how, from the people that I was around, that's what they said. And we were in the rooms one day, and I had the third week, and I had two little girls. One's name was Lulu, and one's name was Mandy, and they were both normal, healthy little girls, except Lulu had a problem with her eye. She could see perfectly, but it was just a little deformed. It was dented in. And if I could take any little kid home, it would have been her. She's 12 years old, and when she turns 13, she can't be adopted anymore. And that's the cutoff. And she just, man, she would just cling to me everywhere I went. She just wanted to be loved. And there was a woman who was cleaning the room, and she was like a housekeeper. And she was talking to my translator, and she was saying, like, it was really awkward. I could tell my translator felt uncomfortable. And the little girls were right in front of them, like, playing, but looking at them. And whenever the housekeeper walked away, I asked my translator, what was she saying? And the woman was asking if they were adoptable and that she was interested in adopting one of them. And for someone to say that, because it's not like America. People don't really adopt there. It's starting to become more of a thing, but it really isn't big there. And so that is her doing a good deed, asking if they're adoptable. But then in the process, she said, I want that little girl, Mandy, because she's healthy. She looks so beautiful. Her eyes are big. She's beautiful. But I could never adopt Lulu just because of her eye. Said that right in front of this little girl who was just crushed. And that woman did not do anything wrong because she doesn't know better. She didn't know better. That's just how it is there. But it is our job to change that. So three things I have to do. One, and this is where, well, all of it you come in, but number one is pray. Pray for their joy every day, those kids. Pray for their salvation. Pray that they get adopted. Number two is adoption. It is so hard for me to tell you to adopt a kid, but if you would be there and you would see them, see a little girl who's 12 years old who desperately wants to be loved, you would find a way. If I was 30 years old and married, I would have adopted. I would still be there because I wouldn't have let her go. So if you are interested, just pray about it. Ask God. Maybe you don't have children. Ask God, is that something I could do? And maybe he'll put it on your heart. And if he does, come talk to me. I have the resources to get you lined up with that. Number three is volunteer. I will be going back every year, and I plan actually maybe praying about in the summer and maybe doing a staff position for 5 weeks and helping run a camp. But I want to get y'all to come with me because it is such an amazing experience and we can change lives together as we develop those long-term relationships and the kids grow up and they still have a relationship with us. They have contact information and we're ministering to them in the gospel. It's an amazing experience and I'm planning on giving y'all more information about that. But just thank y'all and continue praying for them because they need it.
Terry, you want to come? That's why I'm letting you do that.
I'm trying to get my voice back. Thank you, Carrie. You're such a blessing to all of us. We love you. Okay, happy time. Well, we have beautiful children here. These are our freedom fighters who have turned 6 years old. And they will be going up on August 30th upstairs to Miss Duggar's class. We don't want them to go, but they have to go. It's time. So these are our 2014-2015, because most of them have been with us for 2 years, graduates of the Freedom Fighters class. So kids, come on up and on the stage. We have a couple that are not graduating, but they're still up there with their class. Going to stand over here. Feel free to come up and take a picture if you want. And after this is over, we're going to sing one song, but we need all of you to stand up and participate with us if you would. And it will bring out the inner child in you, I promise. Okay, first of all, can the trophy person come over here? Over here? First, we have Chloe Lee. Chloe is Marilyn and Clarence's granddaughter. Alex Plata. Stay right there, buddy. Casey Rath. Jonah Gold Guest. Jorah Guest. Yes, they are twins. Gabrielle Hodge, also known as Gabby. Jesse Young. Dora Devereaux. Yes. Please give a hand for the graduating class of the Freedom Fighters. We're ready, Charlie. Can everybody please stand up?
Thank you. Aerobic exercise for today.
Mike.
I always get to follow the kids. My gosh, they're so cute. Hi, guys. They're beautiful. You know, I like that slogan, Greg. It says, loving God, loving others, living intentionally, right? This is the Freedom Center, the house that love built. Amen. We were talking last week. That's the purpose in our hearts. When we give unto God, it is because we love God. It's an expression of our love. If any of you need a cash envelope, the ushers are passing them out. Kara, you were also showing an illustration of God's love. That's what it's all about, people. That's where your money goes. It's not about people that are trying to do anything as far as building for themselves. It's about people that are trying to build for the kingdom. That's where we are. Father, I thank you so much for your goodness. I ask that your blessings be upon us. God, thank you so much for the things that you have entrusted to us, Lord. For the blessings of our jobs, our families, our children. You've given so much to us, oh God. I thank you for that, God. Now, Lord, I ask for your blessings upon this offering, upon those that are giving. And I ask that each dollar would go three times as far as whatever could be expected because you have blessed it, Jesus, in your name. Amen.
Jesus, I could sing in tongues of men and angels, but if I have not love, I am just a clanging cymbal, an empty sound. Jesus, I could sing in the tongues of men and angels, but if I have not love, just a clanging cymbal, an empty sound. This is a love song. This is a love song. Jesus, a love song to you. A song of devotion, a reverent passion. Savior, a love song to you. This is a love song. This is a love song. This is a love song. Jesus, a love song to you. A song of devotion, a reverent passion. Savior, a love song.
I've been in a flow of worship earlier, and I didn't want to stop. And but we want to do the Lord's Supper, and we've got time for the movie. That'd be okay, but we need to do that. Do this often in remembrance of me. And no greater love hath any man than to lay down his life for another, and that's exactly what Jesus did for us. For God so loved the world, he sent his only begotten Son, Jesus, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but everlasting life, and that he bore my sin upon that cross, and I am so thankful for that. I am thankful that his mercy is new every day. I just love that. His mercy is new every day. I need that reset button. And when we take the Lord's Supper, what this really is it's an opportunity for you just to, for moms, dads, you know, family, for friends, and we're all family here. Just, you know, if you see somebody alone, grab them, bring them in. And even right now, as you're sitting there, you might see somebody. You might just ask them if they want to partake the Lord's Supper with you. But as we do this, what we typically do is the elders will come and partake first, and then they're going to serve you. And then what you'll do is you'll exit from your left and come back on your right side there. But as you do it, it's just a time to inspect your own heart and just to give him thanks for what he did for you upon the cross. And Charlie, if you'd play a little something.
songs of men and names. If I have not love, I'm just a clanging cymbal, an empty sound. Jesus, I could sing with the tongues of men and angels. If I have not love, I'm just a clanging cymbal, an empty sound. This is a love song. This is a love song. Jesus, a love song to you. A song of devotion, a reverent passion. Savior, a love song to you. This is a love song. This is a love song. Jesus, a love song to you. A song of devotion, a reverent passion. Savior, a love. Jesus, I could pray with the faith that moves a mountain. But if I have not love, it is just a noise resounding, an empty sound. Jesus, I could pray with the faith that moves a mountain. But if I have not love, it's just a noise resounding, an empty sound. This is a love song. This is a love song. Jesus, a love song to you. A song of devotion, a reverent passion. Savior, a love song to you. This is a love song. This is a love song. Jesus, a love song to you. A song of devotion, a reverent passion. Savior, a love. This is a love song. This is a love song. Jesus, a love song to you. A song of devotion, a reverent passion. Savior, a love song to you. Overflow of hearts as we gaze upon your beauty, a reflection of your worth. For we've seen a glimpse of you in your glory, Lord. It's the overflow of hearts as we gaze upon your beauty, a reflection of your worth. We've seen a glimpse of you in your glory, Lord. This is a love song. This is a love song. Jesus, a love song to you. a song of devotion, a reverent passion, Savior, a love song to you.
Two things before I move to the movie. One is, Andrew, Svatek, where you at? Are you still in the room? Come here, buddy. It's his last Sunday with us. Can you believe it? The rascal got a scholarship and is taking off to go play football somewhere. Unbelievable. Just pray the Lord's blessing over you and all of our students that are leaving and finding their way to their campuses and getting ready for the school year. But, Lord, I do pray your blessings over Andrew. And, Father, praying blessings over his replacement, Lord, whoever that might be out there that's going to get on that platform and take off leading worship in his place, because we need that. And, Lord, that he'll be infectious wherever he goes, Lord God, that the glory of the Lord will shine off of him. And, Lord, his mouth will be filled with your praises wherever he goes. And he'll be a light and a witness. And he'll be salt to the earth. And he'll be salt to that football team, whether he's quarterbacking or he's on that sideline. It does not matter. He's leading wherever he is at, because he is ordained and anointed by you. And we just give you all the praise, all the glory. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. We'll be seeing him again. But there's another special guy we need to acknowledge. And this is a guy that's, when you say somebody has got your back, he's got my back. And he's had my back for a long time. And he's had the back of Beverly and Curry when they were here for a long time. John Bailey. Come here, John Bailey. We just want to say thank you. Thank you for what you have done. And he's gone off and retired on us and built him a nice retirement home there in New Mexico on the side of a mountain. And he's going to go live the high life, you know. Yeah. And actually, you know, when they, you know, you've seen the commercial where they say it doesn't get any better than this. For him, that's going to be true. It doesn't get any better than this. Yeah. And we're going to find him and visit him. Amen. He'll be back from time to time. But it is a comfort, a peace that you know that you got somebody watching your back. And he's done that for a long time. And John, honestly, we truly thank you for that. Not only look to you for that, but just as a friend and a brother, and how much we appreciate you. And we have something for him. Oh, that's later. Okay. All right.
I'm gonna miss you guys.
We're gonna miss you too. Hey, thank you. All righty, we're fixing to watch a movie. And the gist of this movie that you walk away from is it's not the same-sex marriage issue per se. It's for you to be equipped how to talk to people about Jesus. That's what it's about. And that the good news is good news for everybody. Everybody. Amen? We are all born into sin, for all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. It's what Scripture says. And the wages of sin is death. That's what Scripture says. But the gift of God is what? Life through Christ Jesus. And you got to start getting that line wet, guys. You're not going to catch no fish until the line is in the water. Amen? I went physically fishing this week. I didn't catch a thing. But I went spiritually fishing this week, and I caught something. Hallelujah. But you got to get the line wet. And I think as Ray Comfort speaks here, when you notice, there's a bit of, there's a drama. There's actually a movie. There's drama there. And a real script that you'll follow, but it'll go off into these moments where Ray Comfort's interviewing people on the streets. Now, that's not scripted. That's the real deal. You can go YouTube Ray Comfort and watch. There's tons of videos of him witnessing to people on the streets. And the main thing what he does is that he uses the Ten Commandments. Uses the Ten Commandments because without the Ten Commandments, see, the Ten Commandments is an impasse. And we need that impasse to realize that we are in need of a Savior. We need a Savior. For all have sinned. People have to come to that realization. We can't fashion God in our image and just create a warm, fuzzy God who accepts us just as we are, because that's not the case. We have to deal with the sin issue in our life. And that's what the movie's about. That's what I want you to walk away with. Amen? All right. Let's watch the movie.
The time has come for change. For far too long in this country, too many of us have been afraid to speak up about the things that matter. The time for change is now. So we're going to change American football to rugby. Helmets are for wimps.
All right, sorry. Joking about the president, okay. Joking about football, okay, my bad. The one that I'd love to actually see as the president would be someone like Arnold Schwarzenegger. You know, imagine him trying to fix the problem. You don't worry about the Hummers, you know. I used to drive one, come on. It's fantastic. I love Arnold Schwarzenegger. He's done a movie recently with Sylvester Stallone. Sylvester's like, yo, I'm wondering, you know, would you like a cameo in my latest movie? And Arnie's like, I'm too busy for a cameo. How about a small part? We get call centers ring us in Australia. I don't know if it's the same here. This guy rang me up the other day. He's like, excuse me, Mr. Price. I thought it was my friend doing King Julian. I'm like, oh, the New York Giants. I like to move it. I like to move it. Oh. It was one of those calls. He said, are you interested in doing a short survey? I said, I'm not interested. Okay, question number two. Why not? I'm not interested. Number three, would you ever consider? No! Thank you, come again. If I offend some of you guys, not my intention, because I want to offend everybody equally, if that's okay.
I'm here for the autograph.
Thank
not
you,
yours.
Man. Oh, take my back.
No, I'm human. I better not. So I thought they were going to waterboard you for the rugby thing.
Yeah, I know. It was a risk. Risk I was willing to take.
No risk, no reward, huh?
Hey, so when are you gonna get up on stage and do something?
Me? Next week. Or never, that's what I meant. Never, yeah.
No, seriously, you got some good stuff. You should.
You laugh at anything.
Well, true, but then again, I am just being polite, right?
Well, what do I owe you for that inspiration, Tony Robbins?
No, look, seriously, man. Seriously, I just want to be the first to throw something at you.
Well, you know who liked that joke? Nobody.
Oh, thanks.
Nobody.
Thank you.
So, I noticed you've been talking with the new guy at work. Peter, right?
Yeah, he actually went to high school with me. He used to race bikes.
Motorcycles?
No, bicycles. Like Lance Armstrong.
Oh, cool. He must like his job then. He's doing bike deliveries, right?
Yep, he's a mailman on wheels.
I also noticed that he's been hanging around the guy that sounds like the crocodile hunter.
Yeah, Ben. He's Peter's buddy. He grew up in Australia. I'm actually becoming good friends with both of them. Because our departments somewhat overlap, we spend quite a bit of time together at the office. Ben moonlights as a comedian. He's hilarious. Oh, no.
What?
Haley, Ben's show was tonight, and I totally forgot. Oh, no. He's especially been getting on me about going to this, and I promised I would go.
Ooh. Weston.
I can't believe I forgot. I gotta text him right away. Ugh. I'm so sorry. I beg your forgiveness.
So were you and Peter good friends in high school?
No, not really. We didn't even really know each other. He was just in one of my classes. He was pretty popular, kind of known for being a partier. He's different now, though. Something's changed. I don't really know what it is.
People change.
Yeah. They definitely do.
For some, the legalization of gay marriage is good news, while others find it difficult to grasp. Regardless of what anyone thinks about the issue, gay marriage has become a present-day reality that is spreading across America. Soon, to one degree or another, each of us will have to respond in our own way to this current cultural revolution.
Hi, Peter. Can't believe you're still here. What time's your first delivery?
I'm still trying to wake up.
Oh, Ben's show was last night. No wonder you're tired. How was it?
Oh, it was great. He did so great.
He says you do that, too. You're supposed to be pretty good.
He said that? Yes. I didn't say that. He said that? I wouldn't say that. No.
Can you do one?
No.
Come on.
No.
Oh, come on.
No.
Peter, just do like a little, just like a little one. Nobody's here. Please.
I'm not good. I'm not very good.
That's okay.
All right. You familiar with Russell Crowe? The crazy guy throws phones at people?
Yes.
All right. I can't do him. But I got a mean Popeye.
Wow.
Oh, man, I gotta go soon. Oh, wow.
Are you gonna be on time this time?
I better, because I'm surprised they're letting me do this again.
Everyone makes mistakes.
Yeah, that's true. How many times do you run out of gas? It's like
three
or four.
No,
it's
shut
seven?
Up. Shut up, shut
it
up, shut up.
It was eight-ish.
No.
It was in the eights.
No.
Eight?
It's like once.
Well, yeah. Who's keeping count?
You. What are you looking at?
It's the Bible.
Oh. So you're religious.
Well, I'm a Christian.
Since when?
Like a year ago. Uh-huh.
So, you like believe it, like, you know, that it's all true?
Yeah, every word.
So, do you believe gay people should be stoned?
Of course not.
Well, your book says that.
No, actually, I was reading yesterday, and...
You know what? I don't want to offend you, but I have a sister who's gay. And you don't know the struggle she's been through from people who are telling her that she's going to go to hell for, what, loving someone?
Right.
And you have the audacity to tell me that she's going to hell. Go on, say it.
I'm sorry, I gotta go. I gotta go, I'm sorry.
So, do you believe gay people should be stoned?
Hold on. You do look happy.
Oh, we're getting our application for our marriage license. Can you believe that we're actually doing this?
I know.
Did you call the florist? You know what? We'll just go there next.
Okay.
I feel like there's so much to do, and it's gonna be here before you know it.
I know.
That's a really cool bag. Are you a bike messenger?
Yeah.
So, what's your message?
I'm a bike delivery person. I don't deliver bikes. I guess bike messenger sounds better than bike delivery person. Stamps aren't darn.
Well, have a nice day.
Yeah, you too. Damn. James Armstrong.
Is there a problem?
Yeah, I'm stuck in the elevator. The doors won't open. I'm halfway down the floor.
Okay, there's been a malfunction.
Yeah.
Try pressing the door open button.
It's not working. It's not doing anything. It won't open. I mean, the doors are open, but slightly.
Hang on, I'm entering a code. Okay, now try pushing the doors open.
All right, the doors are open. Thanks.
Okay, now I want you to wait there until the repair crew arrives. Don't let anyone in.
What? No. I have to go. I have to deliver a package.
You don't understand. Someone could die.
I'll figure something out. I can't wait here, okay?
Hey, this is serious. You need to warn people. You cannot leave.
Hey, can anybody help me? Is there anybody here?
What's
this? Hey, you gotta stay and watch this elevator for me. If anybody gets on this elevator, they're gonna die. So just stay here, make sure nobody gets on. I'll be right back.
I still can't believe it. We're getting married. I never thought that I'd be holding this application. Oh, there's a cafe down on the second floor. Let's just eat there. And then the florist isn't too far from here.
Sounds good. What do you think your brother is going to say?
I don't know, but he's gonna have to say something now.
Crawford's been talking with people on the street about what they believe for years. He's not afraid to ask some very personal questions, and as a result, he gets some very interesting answers. Watch this.
I noticed when I came up, you two were kissing in public. You are obviously gay.
Do you think homosexuals should be allowed to be married?
Definitely, 100%.
You two married?
No, we're not married.
Thinking of getting married?
Yes.
What do you think of gay marriage?
I love gay marriage. I have a lot of gay friends. I love the gay community, and I think everybody should be able to love who they want to love, no matter if you love a woman or a man. Who cares?
What do you think of gay marriage?
I'm not opposed to it.
Gay marriage, I think they should be able to do whatever they want.
I think that everyone should be free to marry who they want. Do you think it's morally okay to be gay?
Yes, it is. It's not a lifestyle, it's not a choice, it's who you are. You can't help the fact that you love a man, you can't help the fact that you love a woman.
Do you think it's morally okay?
Sure. I think it is morally okay.
Yes, their choice. They have the same rights as everyone else.
Love is love. Who cares who you love, as long as you're happy.
Are you gay?
I am.
Are you gay?
I am gay, yes.
You gay?
Yes.
When did you discover you were gay?
Last year.
Do you think people are born gay?
No.
So it's they choose to be gay?
Yes, I think they choose to be gay.
Are people born that way?
I believe so. I was.
Do you think people are born gay?
Yes, definitely.
Do you think people are born with tendencies to commit adultery?
I don't know. I don't believe so.
What about to fornicate?
No.
I was born with those tendencies.
everyone's born with a desire to do what we want to do, even if, you know, even if it's wrong. I know adultery's wrong and fornication's wrong, but I still wanted to do it. I was born like it. Couldn't help it. The desires overtook me, but it doesn't make it right. Does that make sense?
That does make sense.
I was born that way. Right from the time I was a little kid when I saw girls, I wanted to be with one. Yeah. Most guys are like that. They got red blood in their veins. I mean, women are attractive. So we're kind of born that way in the sense we like to do that, which is wrong. Fornicate and commit adultery. It comes naturally to us. Does that make sense?
It does.
So do you think the same is the same with homosexuality? People are born with a nature that does what they want to do rather than what God says?
Yes.
Do you think they're born that way?
They're born that way.
For sure? People are born adulterers.
Are born what?
Adulterers.
Like they cheat? Like
you're wanting to cheat on people.
It's in our human nature.
It's in our human nature?
Yeah.
You think people are born fornicators? What do you think?
Actually, it is choice. It is choice.
It's choice? You've changed your mind?
Yeah, you just. You enlightened me real fast. Honestly, this is actually a very good argument.
Does that make sense?
Yes.
That makes
sure,
sense.
Makes sense.
Yeah.
Does that make sense?
Makes sense. Yeah, the way you're saying it logically, it makes sense.
You know, it was so inexpensive, and it's the same as the one we saw in the mall the other day.
It looks so cute on you.
Thank you.
I gotta go, though. I'll talk to you later.
That shirt looks so cute on you.
Stop. You are such a creeper.
Hey, this is gonna sound strange. Do you have a sister?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I do. Why do you ask?
I'll ask you another question, too. Marriage.
Well, right to get married, don't you?
I think there's more to it than that. I'm a Christian in the Bible. The
Bible says a lot of stuff, though. I mean, doesn't it say that God sends gay people to hell?
You're missing the point. Jesus came to save people from hell.
Don't get me wrong. I believe in God. It's just that my God doesn't damn people to hell just because they're different.
Let me show you something. This is a Christian talking to a gay couple.
I'd really rather not. These people are so condescending and judgmental, and why is the Bible so against sex?
The Bible's not against sex. The whole thing starts with God telling two naked people to have sex.
They're literally halfway home. And I know there are psychos out there holding up hateful signs about gay people, but most Christians aren't like that. That's not even Christian. Watch how it ends.
Anything else you'd like to say?
Nope.
You finished?
Yep, I'm all good.
This is me.
For being so, I guess, kind and understanding and not very judgmental about it.
Fine.
Do you believe in God?
Yes, I believe in God.
What does God think of homosexuality?
I think God is okay with homosexuality.
So what does God think of homosexuality?
That's a stupid question.
I think he should just stay out of it.
Are you a spiritual person?
I am, believing God.
Okay. So what does God think of homosexuality?
He thinks it's a thing. He thinks it's wrong.
He frowns upon it, but he still loves me at the end of the day, since we're all sinners.
I know God wants people to be happy.
Since I didn't choose my sexual orientation, so then why would he, if he really didn't like gay people, why would he allow them to roam around the earth? So
well, the same reason he allows adulterers and fornicators and liars and thieves to roam around the earth. That's from the Christian Bible. It's 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verses 9 and 10. Could you read it out loud?
It says, do not be deceived. Neither fornicators, nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor homosexuals, nor sodomites, nor thieves will inherit the kingdom of God.
What do you think of that verse?
That one's really complicated.
It says, adulterers won't inherit God's kingdom, nor will fornicators, nor will homosexuals. So what do you think of that?
It's a nice verse. I'm glad you told that to me.
Could I give you a Bible verse to read and see what you think of it?
No.
Did you hear the second word? It says idolaters. Do you know what that means?
I do not.
Well, an idolater is somebody who makes up a god in their own image. It's a violation of the first and the second of the Ten Commandments, where God says, number one, you shall have no other gods before me. And the second commandment says, don't make yourself a graven image or a false god. We tend to make a God up in our minds that we feel comfortable with, a God that doesn't mind adultery or fornication, homosexuality, lying and stealing. And we cuddle up to that snuggly little God we feel comfortable with, but he's not the God we have to face on Judgment Day. So according to the Bible, will adulterers get into heaven?
No.
Fornicators?
No.
Homosexuals?
No.
That's the warning of Scripture. And if you don't receive that warning, then I can't do anything for you. I'm a Christian and I've got a dilemma. If I say homosexuals won't inherit the kingdom of God, I'm called a hater with hate speech and intolerant. But if I say that will, I'm lying as a Christian because I believe God's word.
Do not be deceived.
Why do you think it begins with those words?
What do you think, Cody?
Why do you think the Bible begins with those words, don't be deceived?
Do not be deceived. I don't know.
Because people are deceived when it comes to this issue.
Okay. I accept Christ into my heart, and that's all that I need to be able to.
Well, no, you got to repent, turn from all sin. No lying, stealing, adultery, fornication, homosexuality. You got to turn from all sin.
I'd be on my deathbed if I really don't believe that I'll make it.
Homosexuals inherit the kingdom of God according to the Bible?
Absolutely not.
Thank you very much, ladies, for talking to me. I really appreciate it.
No worries.
If I care about homosexuals, I'll warn them too. Does that make sense?
That makes, sure, sense. Makes sense, yeah.
Anything else you'd like to say? You finished?
Yeah, I'm all good.
This has been...
For being so, I guess, kind and understanding and not very judgmental about it. Can I go back?
I accept Christ into my heart.
They were Christians.
A lot of people make professions of faith in Christ and then they just continue to live however they want to live. It's called self-deception when we do that. Hey, thanks for letting me talk to you about this. Oh, I gotta... Oh, Ben has a show tonight. You should come to the show.
Sure. Before you go, I just have a quick favor to ask. My brother, Eric, he has really bad cancer. He's dying and he has a wife and three beautiful kids. Why is this happening? What did he do to deserve this? I'm so angry at God.
I'm really sorry that that's happening to you. I'll definitely pray for you.
Hey, what do you think? I think they make me look cool.
Cool. You're trying on sunglasses from a liquor store. Cool is not possible.
You need to get in here?
No hurry.
You two together, or do we have a line?
We're together.
Don't stare, but do you see that guy standing over there? I've been watching him pace back and forth. There's something really weird about him.
Maybe he just needs some sunglasses.
I'm serious. I think he might have stolen something.
You want anything?
I'm good. I don't eat before a gig. Butterflies.
You eat butterflies?
Yeah, I do.
Oh, I got a joke for you, by the way.
Yeah.
Knock, knock.
Really?
Oh. Yeah.
Who's there?
Interrupting starfish.
Interrupting stuff. Oh!
Did you get it?
Yeah.
It's a closer.
I got it. Right in the face.
How about these?
Get on the floor now! Get on the floor now! Get out now! Get down! Everybody get down! Get on the ground. You want to be on the ground or underneath it? Get out. Are those cameras on? Are they recording?
No. No. Yes, yes.
No or yes? Which one?
Yes, yes.
Give me the cash. I need the cash now.
Nobody pays with cash anymore.
Ah!
We aren't calling for the stoning of gays. We aren't calling for the stoning of anyone. Think of the woman caught in the act of adultery. They wanted to stone her to death, but she was repentant. She put her trust in Jesus, and he said, go your way and sin no more.
God, if you can hear me, please protect Peter.
Open the safe or I open her skull.
No, man.
No, please.
No, look, if you hurt her, then you gotta answer to God.
What? What are you, Mother Teresa? Huh? What, am I gonna go to hell?
Hey, just leave her alone. Man, just hand me the gun.
Yeah? You want the gun? How about I give you my bullets instead?
No.
And where are these two gonna go if I pull the trigger, huh?
No, look here, if you're gonna shoot somebody, just shoot me.
Oh, God, I don't
want to
die.
I don't want to die. Just don't shoot anybody, okay?
No, this isn't happening. Who called him? Did you call the cops?
No.
Get up. Shut up. Get out. Get back. Shut up!
Put your gun down!
Back up!
Put it down now and you will not get hurt.
Let her go.
Somebody help
me. It's not worth it, man. Let her go.
Help! Somebody help me!
Back off, I'll shoot her! She's gonna die! And it's gonna be all your fault!
Sir, put your weapon down now!
Put your weapon down!
Put it down now and let her go. No one will hurt you.
Get back! I will shoot her! Go!
Move in! Hurry up! Grab the gun! Stay on the ground! Stay down! Put your hands behind your head!
So what about you? If you were to die today, where would you go? Do you believe in an afterlife?
Oh man, I'm the guy that believes in infinite possibilities.
Do you believe in God's existence?
I don't really have a belief in anything, to be honest.
Now, do you think you're a good person?
Absolutely.
Do you think you're a good person, Kyle?
Yes.
Oh. The way I judge myself, yeah.
I believe I am, yeah.
I'm a fabulous person.
Do you think you're a good person? Are you gonna make it to heaven?
I am gonna make it to heaven.
You think you'll go to heaven or hell when you die?
Definitely.
10 commandments and see.
Yes, I have.
I've done that probably 15 times on the way here.
Have you ever looked at a woman with lust?
I'm gay, so I did not ever look at a woman.
And what about you, Kyle?
Yes, I sure have.
At a guy?
Of course.
Have you ever used God's name in vain?
Yes, I have.
Okay, have you ever used God's name in vain?
Yes.
Okay, that's called blasphemy. Have you done it?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Have you ever used God's name in vain? Oh, my G-O-D.
Oh, yeah.
That's called blasphemy when you do that. So, a little bit of bad news here. I'm not judging you, but by your own admission, you're a lying thief and a blasphemer. And you have to face God on Judgment Day. So if you face God on Judgment Day and he judges you by the Ten Commandments, are you going to be innocent or guilty?
I'll be guilty.
If he judges you by the Ten Commandments, bearing in mind by your own admission, you're a lying thief and a blasphemer, would you be innocent or guilty?
Innocent.
Why?
Because I'm living my life the way he wants me to. I'm going to school. I'm here. I'm not on drugs. I don't have a baby. I'm not married.
I don't have sex every day. I do, I admit it. I should have waited till I got married, but I was young and dumb and I experienced it, and it was a great experience.
Let's back up here. You've just told me you're a lying thief, a blasphemer, and a fornicator, and the Bible says fornicators won't inherit God's kingdom, neither will liars or thieves or blasphemers. So you're in big trouble on Judgment Day. And what about you?
I'll be guilty.
Would you go to heaven or hell?
I would like to think I'd go to heaven.
Well, the Bible says all liars live their part in the lake of fire.
By my standings and where I'm at right now, I will be going to hell. But I would love to go to heaven.
I would hope that I wouldn't end up in hell.
That sounds like I'm going to hell.
Does that concern you?
Yeah, that would concern me.
Yeah, on some level, for sure.
Now, what can you do to be made right with God? How can you be justified? How can you have your sins forgiven? Do you have any idea?
I go to church.
Well, that won't help. You got to do something else.
I'm here at school. I'm living my life.
Yeah, but
I'm here on earth. He put me here for a reason.
But that doesn't wash away your sins. You need a savior, someone who can wash away your sins. So on Judgment Day, you won't receive justice. You'll receive mercy. Because the Bible says if you die in your sins, you'll end up in hell. I'd hate that to happen to you. Now, do you know what God did for guilty sinners so we wouldn't have to go to hell? Any idea? Yeah, do you know what God did so guilty sinners wouldn't have to go to hell? Any idea?
No. No, what did he do?
Well, 2,000 years ago, God became a human being, Jesus of Nazareth, and he gave his life on the cross to take the punishment for the sin of the world. You and I violated God's law, and Jesus paid our fine.
If I die, either way, I'm going to be dead.
Well, would you get, are you sure about that?
Well, nobody knows for sure.
Well, God knows.
That's very true, but we haven't spoken to God.
Well, he's spoken to us through his word. The Bible says very clearly, it's appointed a man once to die, and after this, the judgment. If you stand before God on Judgment Day, in your sins, you'd be guilty, and you'd end up in hell, according to the Bible. That's why you need the Savior. That's why you need what Christ did on the cross. You got to repent of all sin and trust in Jesus alone. If you're in court and someone pays your fine, the judge can dismiss your case. He can say, this person's guilty, but they're out of here because the fine's paid. Well, God can let you live forever. He can commute your death sentence because of what Jesus did on the cross. Suffering and dying for the sin of the world and then rising from the dead. If you're in a court of law and you're guilty, the judge can say, oh, this person's guilty, but the fine's paid, so they're out of here. God can let you live forever because Jesus paid your fine on the cross. Through his life's blood, then he rose from the dead and defeated death. What you've got to do is repent and trust alone in him. Turn from sin and trust in him. It's like you trust a parachute. When you jump out of a plane, you don't try and save yourself by flapping your arms. You can't save yourself. Same with God. You've got to trust alone in Jesus. Don't try and save yourself. That's what the Bible says. Does that make sense?
It does.
And what you have to do is repent and trust in him. The minute you do that, God will dismiss your case. He'll forgive your sins and legally grant you everlasting life. That's the good news of the gospel. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Okay, summation. If you were to die today according to the word of God and God gave you justice, you'd end up in hell. There are two things you have to do to be saved. You got to repent and trust alone in Jesus. When are you going to do that?
Starting today.
In the quietness of your heart, don't wait till you go to church. Today, repent and trust in Christ. That's what I'm saying, so that you're assured of your sins being forgiven. Does that make sense?
It does. I have a question for you. Can you tell that I'm a lesbian?
No. How would I tell that?
No, I'm just saying, do we look like a certain way? Can you tell? Could
no,
you
but
talk to a lesbian for the past 20 minutes?
I pray that God will lead me to the right people, and he's led me to you, and it's...
He did. I'm glad.
It's been great to talk to you. Trust alone in Jesus. He's the only Savior that God has provided. Does this make sense?
Totally makes sense.
Hey, Peter. Did you get done with the police report yet?
Yeah, I just finished.
He almost took a bullet for us in there, and, well, we want to buy you dinner. I mean, just to go our separate ways seems kind of... weird.
Thanks, but I gotta take my buddy to his comedy show. He's late.
Well, is it possible for you to just drop him off and then come with us for a quick bite?
It'd mean a lot to us, really.
All that crime fighting has made me hungry.
Great. Do you know where Tino's is? It's right down the street.
I can meet you guys there 45 minutes.
Cool. Great. All right, we'll see you then.
I still can't believe you did that.
Can I get an iced tea, please? Thank you.
Why would you do that?
Because I like iced tea.
Seriously, though, you don't even know us. You tell that guy to shoot you instead of us.
Yeah, that took a lot of courage.
Actually, I was terrified. But I'm a Christian, so I know where I'll go when I die.
You're a Christian. You know we're gay, right?
Yeah, I figured that when I saw you guys holding hands.
before the guy came out with his gun.
Yeah, but don't most Christians pretty much hate gays?
No, that's not true. We don't hate anyone.
Your table's ready.
Wonderful.
Well, this is a first. I can't say we've ever taken a Christian out for dinner before.
You know, I actually have some questions about the Bible and what it says about being gay.
Really? That's weird. I was just looking into that.
Why? Why would you do that?
Well, I had this crazy nightmare. Mm-hmm. It left me thinking that if I'm not true to what the Bible says about homosexuality, it's like not warning people about a faulty elevator before they step onto it. So if I really love people, then I have to say something. Love can't stay silent.
Okay. Love. Okay, so if God is love, then why is there so much suffering and death? And if homosexuality is such an abomination, then why is the word abomination used to describe eating shellfish? And how come the word homosexuality hasn't been in the Bible until a few decades ago?
Okay, one at a time. So it is true that the word homosexuality wasn't in there because the word hadn't been invented yet. It was coined sometime around 1900. But the original Greek word that was in there, that's the exact equivalent to the modern word of homosexuality. I didn't know that.
Okay, what about the shellfish?
That comes with baked potato and glazed vegetables.
No, we're just not ready to order yet.
Oh, okay, no rush.
Can you give this to Tino, please? Look, here's something that I've been reading. One of these might answer some questions about why God allows suffering. I think you'll find both pretty useful.
Okay, you know what? I think we should go.
What?
We appreciate everything you did, but we're done here.
What's your problem? So you just gave us some Christian stuff.
Let's go.
I'm not going anywhere. What's your problem?
I'm not gonna sit here and listen to this.
He saved our lives. I really didn't mean to offend you guys.
Oh, I know. You and every other homophobe never mean to offend, yet you still tell us that we're going to hell unless we change. And I just heard it all before, and I'm done listening.
Don't do this.
Listen, I am not going back in the closet, and I will not deny my sexuality.
He didn't do anything.
It's fine. Get converted. See if I care. Do not bring that into our home.
I really didn't mean to offend you guys. You didn't do anything. You know, I mean, you could say whatever you want. I won't be offended. No, but I understand why he's mad. I do. Do you understand what it's like to be in our shoes? Do you have any clue, you know, just the basic stuff that we go through? I know that this is complicated. I don't want to sound like a know-it-all, but you two saw what I was willing to do for you today. There are many other Christians that would do the same thing because they genuinely care about you. And I don't doubt that about you. The bottom line is that I believe the Bible. And even though I'm terrified to do it, I have to speak the truth. No matter what people think of me, it's not even about me. It's about this wonderful, loving God that sent his son to die on the cross and rise from the dead so that sinners could be forgiven and have everlasting life.
Okay, so what can I get for you guys?
We're not ready. But you're doing a great job. Here's $1 million under the table.
Now I can quit. Oh, more than just some vain emotion. True love does what others fail to do.
care about you. So I won't let the world around us tell me what to think or say or do. You know it's true. So don't you know love, love can't stay silent. It's gotta wake the world. Oh, it's gotta tell the truth.
I don't know how many people know The Simpsons. I've got the Homer Simpson GPS. You'll be driving along the 71. We're gonna take the next exit on the left. Wait, was it the left or was it the right? Hang on, think. What are we gonna do? I don't know, just stop here for some donuts. Donuts, is there anything they can't do?
Who wants to come for a drive with me? They remade Charlie and the Chocolate Factory. Johnny Depp got the role. Robert De Niro was asked to play the role of Willy Wonka. Can you imagine Robert De Niro, Willy Wonka?
Hey, listen to me, Charlie. Hey. Don't mess with me. Hey, don't mess with me. You are good. Yes, you are. You gotta get, yes, you do. I am watching you. Hey, thank you. Hey.
Come on, y'all, one more time. Give it up. Come on. Great. All right. Please, he wasn't that funny. All right. Consider this a union gig. We're going to take a 5-minute break. If you're a government worker, that's about an hour. Everybody else, 5 minutes. Going back, get yourself an overpriced watered-down drink. 5 minutes, everybody.
Oh, I'm so glad you're okay.
Yeah, that was crazy, wasn't it?
I can't believe that happened to you.
Me neither.
I actually prayed.
No, you didn't.
Yeah, I did. I can't remember the last time I did that.
Wow. Well, thank you very much.
So I've been watching the videos that you showed me, all day today. And I haven't told anyone this yet. But I'm kind of starting to feel a little nervous because it's starting to all make sense.
Right.
You know, the whole thing about heaven and hell.
Right. So you understand the gospel, the main message of the Bible?
I think so. We're sinners and Jesus can save us.
Right. Well, Jesus came to die on the cross for sinners. Yeah. So when you turn away from sin and you put your faith in him, then you're saved from the punishment you deserve.
Oh, sorry, I have to take this real quick.
Yeah.
Hey, Katie, what's going on?
Eric isn't doing good at all. I need to take him to the emergency room right now. Can you watch the kids?
Yeah, of course, I'm on my way.
Welcome back, everybody. Thank you very much for being here once again. Can I tell you, you're a better crowd than last night. That's all I don't want to insinuate that they weren't very bright, but flattery will get me everywhere. The crowd last night, if the joke didn't begin with knock, knock, it was a little rough. I would like to introduce our next act, but apparently he's about as punctual as Axl Rose. We don't have a next act, is what I'm trying to tell you. And I'm really not even kidding. We don't have a next act.
What? It's ridiculous.
Okay, so here's the deal.
I want my money back.
You can all be really mad, start throwing stuff at me, or we could keep this party going because we're like the NSA. I happen to know that there are some people in this crowd tonight who are actually funny. In fact, the whole night you've been looking up here and going, I could be funnier than that guy.
Yeah, I ran out of gas.
So now is your chance. Where are our wise guys. And just in case you need to be bribed, the food here, almost better than airplane food, will actually feed you and your table if you're willing to come up here. Where is our first funny man?
Hi, Peter. It's Diana. Sorry I had to go earlier. I just wanted to let you know that I've really been thinking about everything we've been talking about, and I've even been feeling bad about my sin. Yeah, I said the word sin.
Hey, Claudia here.
You guys like impersonations?
Yeah.
All right, this is Russell Crowe.
Are you not entertained?
And if you're not entertained, I'll throw a phone at your face.
I just wanted to let you know that I've really been thinking about everything we've been talking about, and I've even been feeling bad about my sin. Yeah, I said the word sin. Anyway, I've actually been reading the Bible, and it's really making me think. But I'm not quite there yet. I definitely have some questions. So as I've been reading, I've noticed that God often gives people second chances. And I like that because I could use a second chance. So I just wanted to say thanks. I know I've been arguing with you about God and stuff, but you've been nice enough to put up with me. So, thank you for not giving up on me. You're a true friend.
A dramatic rescue happened just hours ago when a woman was almost crushed by an oncoming train. The rescue effort almost turned tragic when the victim refused to be rescued. I spoke with the hero's cousin earlier.
My cousin said that when the train was coming, he was trying to get her out of the car, but she just kept screaming at him and looking at him like he was evil or something. I mean, he had to break the car window just to get her out. She didn't understand what he was trying to do. I mean, she thought he was trying to hurt her. What she didn't realize is he was actually trying to save her.
So there you have it, a selfless act of courage from an apparent enemy who turned out to be a friend.
You know, the point of this today is to equip you. What I love about Ray Comfort is watching him talk to some people who have some wild world views. and he doesn't get bent out of shape. He doesn't get angry. He just goes with it, you know. And because here's the deal. You have a different worldview. You have a different worldview because you're not of this world. And so they have a different worldview because they're not yet of the same world of which you're of. And that's why their worldview is different. And you shouldn't be shocked that they have a different worldview. And just enter into that process. Cast that line out there. And be equipped. Scripture says we're to be prepared. We're to be ready to share that faith, that hope within us concerning Christ Jesus. And so that's what this was about today. And I pray that that encourages you. I pray that it equips you. Pray it shakes you a little bit, makes you think a little bit. Amen. But I pray over you, and we're going to close here in a moment, that you have divine appointments, that the Lord just gives you divine appointments, that you recognize those divine appointments the Lord lays before you, and that you'll be prepared how to deal with it. Somebody shared in the first service a testimony just from last Sunday when I was sharing with you, your best response to an atheist sometimes is not talking scripture, because they go online and try to figure out what to throw at you to trip you up. But what you can do, which they cannot deny, is your experience with God. You just testify of your experience with Him. That's all you got to do. And so she clicked to that in the midst of that conversation and just began to tell that atheist about her experience with Jesus Christ and how Jesus changed her life. Wasn't anything that that person could say back to that other than, wow, that's interesting. And so that's what you do. Be prepared to speak concerning the hope that's within you. Christ Jesus. Amen. Everybody stand. Father, I speak over this congregation. Lord, your word says we are the light of the world. That's what your word says. Your word says that we are salt to the earth. And Lord God, that your last command that you spoke to your church as you ascended into the heavens was, go ye therefore teach all nations, and that we're to baptize them in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, and that we're to teach them all the things that you taught us. And Lord, that's our heart. Lord, as we put that the Lord's Prayer back up on that wall, that thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth just as it is in heaven. We want to participate in heavenly things every day, Father. Let us realize, Lord God, that you have assignments for us. When we wake up tomorrow morning and we go through our normal routine of getting up and going to work, whatever we're doing, Lord God, that we would just ask you, Lord, who is it you want me to speak to today? What's my assignment today? What do you want me to participate? Heavenly things on earth. What is it you want me to do today? And I pray, Father, for testimonies that begin to flow over, Father, of people experiencing you and just seeing those assignments, Father, having ears to see it, having ears to hear, and participating in that. And, Father, just seeing the fruit that's going to come forth that. Make us a church, Lord God, that advances your kingdom by telling others about what Jesus did for us. We thank you for your grace. We thank you for your mercy, Lord God. We thank you that it endures forever, as we were singing about today. It endures forever. We thank you, Lord. You are worthy of praise. I pray if anyone here today doesn't know Jesus, that they'll have the boldness just to come and to ask, and Lord, to be able to talk to them about receiving you into their life and realizing that their need for a Savior. I thank you, Lord God, for your word. I thank you for your truth. I thank you, Lord, that the gospel is good news for everyone. And we praise you and we thank you for that. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. God bless you.